walk around the compound, see some Thai hackers, yeah!
Oh my goodness, hello.
Hello, how are you? Shadow, I have a shadow on you. Zoobs. Zoobs, Mr. Zoobs.
Oh, and sleepy Mr. Ra. Sleepy Mr. Ra. What a sweetheart. What a sweetheart. What sweet little boys. Sweet, wonderful, lovely little boys.
Not like those dirty, dirty tikis.
Hello, all you big cat lovers out there. It's me, Derek, again. Welcome to another super duper splendid, fantastic, wonderful walk around the compound webcast. Look at these pretty girls.
Hi.
Well, hello, Miss Fire. Hello, Miss Firebug. I don't have much of an agenda. The only agenda I have is trying to do a webcast because it is Tuesday. It's Tuesday today, the day that I'm actually filming this webcast. It is Tuesday, and normally I would have a webcast already posted by now. Oh my goodness, but yesterday, it was a busy day. It was a busy day. And I had to tweet it out. I had to tweet out like, sorry. Sorry. I wasn't able to film a webcast. Hashtag no one died. Hashtag don't worry. Hashtag don't panic. Hashtag all is good. Calm yourselves. Because I've had a couple of people in the past, when I say like, I can't film a walk around the compound webcast. And then they're like, what does this mean? What happened? Who died? Is everything okay? I suppose it actually has to do with the fact that there was one time I did that. Where I tweeted something out and I said like, so everything's so busy, oh my gosh. But it was because we actually had a cat get sick and pass away. And then I think people were just like, oh no, I thought it was. And my suspicions were confirmed, my paranoia. My paranoia was confirmed. Savannah banana. We just fed last night. So there are various states of meat comas happening all over the place. Oh, but yeah, it's busy because we're down one intern on all we got. So Hope went away and all we got is Lily. Creaky gate. Walk around the gate cast. It's like a fork being scraped on your teeth during a root canal while the dentist is rubbing his nails on the chalkboard. Hi, bud. While the baby's crying. Hey! Yeah, you're pretty cute. Look at these chubby boys. Those little chubsters. They're little chubsters. They're getting so big. They're getting so big. So big. Hey, Slade. It's like I try to get on my haunches, down on my laurels. Not my hearties, my laurels. And I sometimes will lose my balance. Oh my goodness. Yep. Craig's been doing pretty good. It's been, you know, it's been really rough, of course. I mean, like, he, you know, lost the love of his life, but sometimes, like, and this is how guys work, this is how guys are. Sometimes you gotta kinda like get them out of the house and you gotta kinda get them with some bros and they'll have some good bro time, go out for some beers. Although they have to use their fake IDs because they're not old enough yet because they're little tiggies. And some bouncer holding up there. Is this really you? It's actually like they're holding, they have a picture of like a white tiger with a bad comb over. Boomer's like, yeah. Yeah, bro. It's me. Sleepy kitties. Whoa, what am I doing? I wasn't even looking at the screen. Ah, I wasn't even looking at the screen. Let it just, let it just get all askew. Oh my gosh, look at him. He's got his little tongue out. Chompers. It's December. It's December. And it's like in the 70s right now. What? What? This is just nuts. But it's been like, you know, Texas. December in Texas. Goes up, it goes down. The weather gets crazy. Crazy. Whoa. What doing, Luca? I am moving it over here. It was over there, and I moved it over here because I like this spot better. Don't ask me why. I just do. Huh. Alrighty. Duh. Oh! Oh, you're so ugly. You're so ugly. It's disgusting. It's gross. You should wear paper bags over your heads. What are you doing? Oh, playing with their stuffed animals. Oh, stinky facing on their stuffies. Stinky stuffies. Is that going to be the title of the web? Oh, this schedule, man, especially this time of year, this schedule superimposed over this time of year, pretty brutal. But got a surprise, Heidi. Oh my gosh, big surprise. She snuck over to my place, my other place, far, far away, and she furnished my apartment, while I was at work, and I got off of work, and I went to my apartment, and there was actually, like, the remnants of, like, civilized living there, which was crazy, because I consider myself to be, you know, I don't need terribly too much. I'm able to subsist off of Spartan accommodations, Pete Shake. So I didn't really have terribly too much in the old apartmentaroo. Like, seriously, I had like fold-up chairs, like an air mattress, a beanbag chair. It was pretty pathetic. But I, it's like, and it would have stayed that way. It would have stayed that way for years. I'm just like, whatever, that doesn't bother me. And of course Heidi is just like, no, you gotta like actually be a person. And I'm like, I suppose, but I'm not gonna do it. And that's the other thing, it's because she says like, look, I don't know what to get you, you know, for Christmas. I don't know what to get you for Christmas, because like whenever you just like want something, but there's a butt. It's a tiger butt. A Polly butt. Papa! He's not even lifting up his head. He's still breathing, but he's just not lifting up his head right now. She's like, I don't know what to get you. Because whenever you want something, you just go and get it. You just go and buy it yourself and ruin it for everyone. Ruin it for all the people who care about you. Sorry. I'm sorry, I'm just difficult like that. But she knew, she's just like, no, Derek is a mess. And like, he'll never take the time to actually make his living situation more palatable, more in line with how like normal actual people choose to live their lives. Like I said, Spartan. I won't need a lot. But yeah, she actually, and she took all of her kids. She took the kids, and I mean, the apartment's on like a second floor. They moved couches, a full like queen size bed, the dinner dining room set, and they assembled everything. It was nuts. How they did it, and I came in. I literally, I'm not joking. I did this. I got off my shift. I go to my apartment. I put my key in. I open up the door. I see like there's a Christmas tree and like some chairs, like couches. And I'm just like, oh no. I closed the door because I thought I opened up. What are you doing? I'm telling a story. And I closed the door. I'm like, oh no, whose apartment is this? I didn't think it was mine. I'm just like, oh no. And then I'm like, how did my key work for this other person's apartment? And I looked around and I'm just like, this is mine. And I opened the door back up and there's my family. And it was like, oh my gosh, you guys did this for me? That was so cool. That was so cool of them to do that. Selena. Oh my god. But yeah, that was I was floored. I was speechless. Absolutely speechless. Excuse me. What? Just because I'm not hanging out with you right at this very moment? Besides, when I do hang out with you, all you want to do is just jump at the fence and be all crazy. So, like, what is that? This is, like, a weird... That's not, like, a friendship. Okay? It's not. I'm not going to subject myself to that. This sort of treatment, Selena. This enclosure's been active past few days. Noe and Wally have been... they've been bumping the uglies, so to speak. For a long, long, long time. And a lot of times what they'll do is they'll engage in activities inside of their tower over there, that big metal tower, which just echoes. The sounds of their passion just echoes everywhere. And who was it? I think it was Lily who was saying, like, she had a tour. She was doing a tour and they were doing that. They were banging. And, just kind of made it awkward. Well, you know, that's animals, that's what they do. Did you know that a lion's roar can be heard from up to 2 miles away? Did you know that only the males have that hair on their head? It's called a mane. Lions have retractable claws. They live in social groups called prides. Because that's the sound they make when they have sex. It's not, it's certainly not like pleasurable, like, you know, yay, passion sounds. It's like violent, just, which you guys have heard that stuff. You've seen it in different various webcasts. Oh, sleepy Milo. Yeah. Christmas. I love Christmas. Love it. I'm a Christmas junkie, like the dad on Christmas Story. Christmas junkie. Love it. Both Heidi and I, Christmas junkies. Christmas junkies, just put the Yuletide in my veins.
Sass. Sass. Sass.
And squeak. Oh no, my phone. I caught it though. Goodness. Pikachu. Not having it. Not having it. She says, no thank you. Come again later. It is the most wonderful time of the year. Most wonderful time of the year. It's time for... It's overly commercialized and it's just an excuse for the corporations to make money off of the people, man. Shut up. It's a celebration of warmth, of family, of happiness, and it's the end of the year and you get to take some time off and you get to have some good food and you get to be around the people that you love. Look at it like that. Don't look at it like a cynical person, like a cynic. You know, also if, you know, you're of the Christian variety, it's also the, you know, birth of the baby G. So that, sprinkle that one on top. But I don't even think you have to be Christian, honestly, to really enjoy Christmas, to just love it. Christmas can be for everyone. It can be. Why not? Why not? Besides, a lot of the traditions of Christmas actually come from, like, old pagan things, you know? People wonder, like, well, where do the evergreen trees come into play? That was, because hey, Christmas to December 25th, it's, you know, the winter solstice, and that was already, like, a Roman celebration. They were heavily ingrained into that, into celebrating the winter solstice. I probably should have researched this a little bit more, but I do know that that was the thing. And besides, it was the early Christians, when they were converting Rome, it was a lot easier to get, like, Romans on board if you just took pre-existing holidays. And then you said, like, oh yeah, well, by the way, we can celebrate some of the Jesus stuff too. Helps out. And then the Romans were like, sweet, we don't have to change anything on our calendars. Nice. And then but then they maintained a lot of the old traditions. That's where do you think eggs and bunnies come from? Eggs and bunnies during Easter, because the time that they would celebrate Easter back in the day, it was actually a fertility celebration. It was a pagan Roman fertility celebration, and that's where bunnies and eggs, symbols of fertility, come from. Yeah, leftovers. I like history. History's fun. It's fun stuff. But yeah, Christmas, most wonderful time of the year. Most wonderful time of the year. For a lot of different reasons. For a lot of different reasons, for a lot of different people. And I think that that's a good thing. Hey, Raven. Funny thing about I was even thinking about this the other day. That circumcision was actually had a big role to play in getting the early Romans to convert over to Christianity. It was because, and it was spreading like wildfire throughout, like, the you know, the end of the Roman era. And there was a lot of Romans who were just like, I like this whole Christianity thing. It's fun. It's awesome. Wanna jump on board. I don't need to be doing this old Zeus stuff anymore. Don't need to be praying to Hera. You know? Or actually, no, it's Jupiter. Sorry. Oh, so sorry. I'm getting my Greek mythology mixed up with my Roman mythology. There were early Christians who told the Romans, like, well, first you got to convert to Judaism, which means that you have to get circumcised, and then you can convert from Judaism to Christianity. And a lot of Roman dudes were just like, I don't know if I like that. Like, I don't know if I like that part. Can we just skip the one, you know? Can we just go to the from here to over here? I mean, it just seems like a lot of steps. Seems like a lot of steps, a lot of red tape. So that's when, you know, and then they realize, like, well, you know, we can increase our quarterly conversions by 38% if we allow them just to become Christians right away. And they did, and it worked. And the Romans were like, yay, I don't have to do that. It's one thing to do it to when you're a baby, but when you're like a grown dude and you're living in ancient Rome where there's no anesthetics, the idea of doing some schmagerken snipping doesn't sound too appealing. It doesn't. This has been an interesting webcast. But that's kind of where a lot of that come from. We gave Tess a body of a cow. The body of cow. Peace be to you. We gave Tess body of a cow, and she's pretty stuffed. And she's doing pretty good. Lily was sitting there saying, like, we're gonna give that to her. She's gonna be a lunatic tomorrow. She's not gonna wanna lock up. And it's just like, no, sometimes, like, you hit a certain point where if you just give them a whole bunch of food, then they get so stuffed that they don't want to protect it anymore. They're just like, oh, boy, I don't even care about food. And, and besides, that cow, it was, like, really skinny. It could feed one voracious cat or two really, really skinny cats. But not, like, Fire Melita. Wouldn't be able to feed Fire Melita. It could feed a Tess. Tess is one of our best eaters. She is one of our bestest of eaters. Hi, baby. Hello. Oh, look at these bellies. Look at these big bellies. So many big bellies. Yeah, I'm doing a thing. I'm gonna be filming a thing. You'll see it soon enough. But, filming a commercial. Gonna be testing some products. Don't wanna give too much away. Sid. And it's going to be Sydney and Rasa who are going to be helping me out. So, that's cool. That's a pretty cool thing. All right. All righty. Well, I got stuff I got to do. And things and whatnot. So, I will talk to you folks later. Okay, well, see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.